Good morning. Welcome to Holy Mass. Today is the memorial of Saint Teresa of Jesus, a virgin and doctor of the Church. Our Mass is being offered for the intentions of John and Maria Cohen. Our celebrant is Monsignor Murray. Our entrance hymn is 10,000 Reasons, number 560 in the Breaking Bread. 560 in the Breaking Bread.
And with your spirit.
Boys and girls, Christian friends, we come together as a Lord's family, turn with confidence to God our Father, and ask His forgiveness for our sins, knowing as we do that it's full of gentleness and compassion. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father and intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through your Spirit raised up St. Teresa of Jesus to show the Church the way to seek perfection, grant that we may always be nourished by the food of her heavenly teaching and fired with longing for true holiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all creation is groaning and making labor pains even until now. And not only that, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit. We also groan within ourselves as we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we were saved.
one sees for herself is not right. For who hopes for what one sees? But if we hope for what we cannot see, we wait with endurance. In the same way, the Spirit too comes to the aid of our weakness. We may not know how to pray as we ought, but the Spirit himself intercedes with an interest of Christ. And the one who searches hearts knows what is the intention of the Spirit, because he intercedes through the Holy Ghost, according to God's will. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit. And every one that does, he prunes so that it bears more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word I spoke to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine. You are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit. Because without me you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me will be thrown out like a branch withered. People will gather them and throw them into a fire, and they'll be burned. If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today is the feast of St. Teresa, the little flower. She's a young girl of France who wanted to be a great hero. She wanted to be a martyr in the church. She loved God very much. She really wanted to die for him, to do dramatic and beautiful things. But God had other plans for her. And instead of becoming a martyr or even a great scholar, great teacher, a preacher, he called her to the convent as a young, very young girl. And she didn't live very long. She died as a very young woman. And yet we proclaim her today as the doctor of the church. She's one of the great teachers throughout the history of the church. And yet she didn't write to go to a book or her diary, which we had, and it's very beautiful. It teaches us a lot. She's not a scholar like St. Thomas Aquinas or St. Catherine of Siena or even the other St. Teresa, she named it, who was a great doctor in the church. She is famous for her little way. She learned what was really important was simply doing many little things, but doing them with a great deal of love. She had a great personal relationship with God. Her life centered around her prayer. And even though she died at a young age, we acclaim her as a really great and special saint because she's someone that we can all follow. We may not all be sisters, as she was a sister in a convent, in a cloistered community. We may not be great teachers, we may not be martyrs, but each of us is called to serve God in our own particular unique way. The important thing isn't the title that we have, or even exactly what we do, but how we do it. That we're united with the vine that we heard about in the gospel. That everything we do comes out of the love that God has for us, and that we open ourselves to accept and to share with one another. We tap it out every time we come to the Lord's table and eat of his body and drink of his blood. And remember how much he loved us. Open ourselves to his life. And then Teresa of Lisieux, like all the saints, what kind of their ways go out and live his life. I pledge you to do that each time we come, remembering him in the breaking of the bread. Stand now and lift up our petitions. Trust in God's care for us, we offer these prayers to him. Mm-hmm.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, may they be given the vision to see and respond to the needs of every person, especially the most vulnerable. Let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who feel defeated in whatever their daily battles are, we're all in need of any kind of healing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community of faith, may the Holy Spirit continue to let us help and grow in faith, hope, and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died in the light of faith, may they be welcomed into God's glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Mark, Worley, Pauline Winterbottom, Barbara O'Quinn, to all those who are on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intention of John and Anne Marie Cohen, for which this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our offer for him is Hail Mary, gentle woman, whom the
bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promised in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as we bow in. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor.
the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, according to your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all."
Thank you.
St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Our sexual hymn is Blessed Be the Lord, number 431 of the Breaking Bread.
What are you...